Hi student, good morning. Yes, welcome back to our quadrilateral lecture.
Yes,
in the quadrilateral we are discussing some of the lengthy problems here. I hope you are getting it is little bit lengthy how to solve. Nothing is difficult here. Everything it is very easiest thing. Just with the pictures we are playing here. No, really, our quadrilateral all solution our quadrilateral with the picture he has given me. Now they immediately just we have to show that. Yes, it is a very easiest concept here, but little bit lengthy. Don't worry, we can take it. Yes, yallaru ayithikku mani valaga irthirath ankonde haudalla na na guess maadi correct aithe ankonteeni. Some of you are laughing. Miss now ellavu wrong mark bartivi, erdu wrong mark bartivi. You can go outside. It is not my question, but you should be safe. Yes, during this COVID-19, you should be very safe. Wear the mask, use the hand wash, otherwise sanitizer. And if you are going outside, please make the social distance. Yes, student, your life is very precious. Yes, because of your life, at least your life before you should be. Maintain the social distance if you are going outside. Yes, okay. Now come to your question. What is that? A B C D is a one of the quadrilateral or parallelogram. Yes, this is a one of the parallelogram. Here two points P and Q. These two are the points P as well as Q. Yes, on the diagonals of diagonal BD such that here your DP is equal to BQ. Means this line I have drawn DP which is equal to BQ. Then you have to show that the first thing is the triangle ABD which is congruent to the triangle CQB. ABD which is congruent to the triangle CQB.
Because alternate interior angle, then we can
got these two triangles are congruent, then the corresponding parts are equal here. In a congruent triangle, the corresponding parts are equal. Yes, already we proved triangle ABP, which is congruent to the triangle CBQ. If these two triangles are congruent, then we can decide AP equal to CQ by CPC. Yes, congruent parts of corresponding triangles are equal here. By using the CPCD, these two are equal. Then our third question is, show that triangle AQB, it is congruent to the triangle CPD. Just take these two triangles. It is AQB. AQB. It is congruent to the triangle CPD. What? CPD. It is congruent to the CPD. It is same order. First thing we know, BQD is same as BP. Yes. This already got. BQD is same as DP.
AQ, which is equal to
See, if one pair of opposite sides are equal as well as parallel, then it should be one of the parallelogram. Otherwise, come here, AP equal to CQ. AP equal to CQ. Two pairs of opposite sides are parallel as well as equal. Yes, here AP equal to QC and AP it is parallel to QC. And same way, AQ it is equal to BC and AQ which is parallel to BC. This shows the quadrilateral APCQ is a parallelogram. The easiest thing is it is a parallel. Yes, just pause the video and take it. I think you have written. Next we will go to the 10th question here. What is the 10th question we will take now? Yes, take your 10th question. Here A, B, C, D is one of the parallelogram. And AB and CQ are two perpendiculars from vertex A to diagonal BD as well as from the vertex C to diagonal B. Yes, these two are perpendiculars. And here we have to show that what? Your triangle APB and triangle CQB are congruent to each other. And one more thing, your AB it is same as CQ. AB which is same as CQ. Yes, so we get it now. Okay, now comes to the triangle APB and CQB. CQD. Okay, this is a triangle. What? APB. APB. And this is a triangle CQD. Yes. CQD. Yes. Here angle PD is right angle. Yes, perpendicular with the intersect. And just observe here AB and CD are equal. But because AB and CD are opposite sides of the parallelogram. Yes, the opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal as well as parallel. And one more thing, here angle P it is same as angle Q. Why? Because those two are perpendicular to the BD. Yes, angle P it is same as angle what? Q. Both are right angles. And next thing is, here it is triangle CDQ. Is same as ABP. Why? Because here AD and BC are parallel and your DB is a transversal and angle CDQ and ABP are alternate interior angles. So by using AAS criteria, we can take these two triangles here. Congruent. Yes, so we take it now. Okay, these two angles also equal. Then we can decide by AAS these two triangles are congruent. Yes, in these two triangles, angle APB which is equal to CQD, both are 90 degree, and AB which is equal to CD, opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram. Yes, they are equal. And one more thing, your angle ABP equal to ABP equal to CQD because alternate what? CDQ because they are alternate interior angles, alternate interior angles. Then by using first question. What is the second question here? Answer that AB is equal to CQ. If even these two triangles are congruent, the corresponding parts AB is same as CQ. Yes. So already we wrote triangle ABB, which is congruent to the triangle CQD. Then it shows AB equal to CQ by using what? CPCD. The corresponding parts of the congruent triangles are equal here by using CPCD. Where AB equal to what? CQ. Yes, this is the 10th question. Just pause the video and take it. Next, we will go to the 11th question. Yes. So just to take it. Yes. Come here. The 11th question. Yes. What is the question here? A, B, C and D, E, F are two triangles. Here, AB, this AB which is equal to DE as well as AB and DE are parallel. And same way, BC which is equal to EF and BC is parallel to EF. Then what we have to do? Join A to D. Join the vertices A to D and B to E, C to F. Yes, what he has given? Join the vertices of A, B, C, D to D, E, F with respect to them. Then come to the question here. We have to prove that the quadrilateral A, B, E, D. A, B, E, D. It is a one of the parallelogram. Yes, this is a one of the parallelogram. Just observe here, he has given AB. It is equal to D as well as AB. It is parallel to D in a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, the face of opposite sides are equal as well as parallel. Yes, the face of opposite sides are equal as well as parallel. Yes. So if two opposite sides of a quadrilateral, yes, here given that what? AB which is equal to D and AB which is parallel to D. Already we know if what two opposite sides of a quadrilateral are equal and parallel, then it is a parallelogram. Yes, two opposite sides. Yes, AB and we can take AB is opposite to, yes, what? D. The two opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal as well as parallel. Then it shows the AB, ED. AB, ED is a one of the parallelogram. Is it real or not? Just hear the state. Yeah, not to go here. Yeah, opposite sides are equal as well as parallel. So it is a parallelogram. Next condition, next question. Show that BEFC. Take here. B, E, F, C. So for that purpose, I have taken here separate picture. B, E, F, C is a one of the what? One of the parallelogram. Just observe here in the given thing. Even BC, it is equal to EF as well as BC, it is parallel to EF. BE, it is equal to CF as well as BE, which is parallel to CF. If two opposite sides of the quadrilateral are equal as well as parallel, same condition you have to apply, then it becomes a what? One of the parallelogram. Yes, here even BE, which is equal to CF, and BE is parallel to CF, and BE is opposite to what? CF. BE is opposite to CF. This shows your BEFC is a parallelogram. Same condition. Both sides same condition. Yes. And so next thing is show that AD is parallel to FC and AD is equal to FC. AD parallel to what? CF or FC.
as well as 18, which is equal to 1 cm. What to do? Yes, already we know that the quadrilateral A, B, E, D are B, E, F, C are parallelogram. Yes, they are parallelogram. Already we know that what A, B, E, D. A, B, E, D and B, E, F, C are parallelograms. If they are parallelograms, then their opposite sides are equal as well as parallel. So here AD, ED is opposite to BE. Yes, AD, ED is opposite to BE. And same way, this AD, ED is opposite to CM. Okay, AD, BE is opposite to AD. If BE and CM is opposite to AD, automatically AD, ED is opposite to CM. Yes or no? Otherwise, you can come here. AD it is opposite to CM. Yes. Okay. You can take AD equal to what? B. AD which is equal to B and AD it is parallel to AD equal to B and AD it is parallel to B and same way B which is equal to CM and B it is parallel to CM. Automatically you can take what? We can take AD, AD is parallel to CF and equal to CF. It shows AD, it is parallel to CF and same way AD which is equal to CF. Yes, opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal as well as parallel. So AD, B is same AD and B and CF is same AD. Same way AD is equal to CM. And comes here next one. Show that ACFD is a parallelogram. Where is your ACFD? ACFD is a one of the parallelogram. Already we have proved here AD is parallel to CM and AD is equal to CM. One pair of means two opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal as well as parallel. Then we can conclude it is a parallelogram. Otherwise, come here already we have given AC and DM. Here they are also parallel. Otherwise, already we proved. We proved now what your AD it is equal to CM and AD which is parallel to CM. It shows your ACFD is a parallelogram. We have both of the parallelogram. One pair of opposite sides are equal as well as parallel. Next thing is show that AC equal to DF. AC which is equal to DF. AC DF DM is one parallelogram. Another pair of opposite sides are also equal here. Yes or no? Already we proved AC FD is a parallelogram. Then AC and FD are opposite sides of parallelogram. This shows your AC which is equal to DF or FD. DF or FD. Yes sir. Adu parallelogram ayyu adukku adu opposite sides equal aagum. So next question is show that triangle ABC is congruent to the triangle DEF. A, B, C, it is congruent to the triangle D, E, F. Yes, take the triangles A, B, C and D, E, F. Okay. A, B, C, D, E, F. You will have congruent along the torso. Hey, Madhudriga. Yes, what are the things are same here? AB equal to D, E as given. And BC equal to EF also given. And one more thing. What? DF equal to AC already we proved here. Yes. So given that AB which is equal to DE and BC equal to EF and V proved already your AC which is equal to what? BF. Then by using SAS condition we can take the triangle ABC which is congruent to the triangle DEF by using what? By SSS congruence condition we can prove this is a part of the what? Congruent triangles. Yes, just pause the video and take it. Okay. The last question of this exercise means 12th question. What is the 12th question here? ABCD on the trapezium quotari. Quota, we need AB is parallel to CD and quotara and same way AD is equal to BC and quotara. You get one the angle A equal to angle B, angle C equal to angle D. Where triangle ABCD is congruent to the triangle BAD manam thirara. Adu shodhi one hint quotari. So just you extend the AB length up to E. Just you have to extend it. And same way you have to intersect the AB line by using the by drawing the line from C to E up to intersecting the line AB. Avagena avatre CE matha BC equal sides antava. Then you can show angle A equal to angle B as well as angle C equal to angle D and you can take the two triangles are congruent. I hope you can do that. Yes, with this, the problems which based on the totally parallelogram properties of the parallelogram is over. So in the next session, we will take the next concept. Yes. So just today, I have given only 3 questions to you as a homework. That is also similar. Are you ready to solve? Yes, you are feeling so good. You can do that. So first you have to take it and solve those. Yes, in the next video, we will take a new concept here. Yes, take it. Bye-bye.